Good morning.
Yeah, it is. Anytime I wake up next to you.
How are you feeling?
Well, now that's what I call nursing. I'm here to examine the patient.
Well, you know what? His name is Jason. Thank you. And, we outside, okay?
You're a lucky man. Not just because I'm your surgeon. So what's your story? This is me acting interested in you as a patient, not just a person, as per request from Dr. Scorpio. Why'd the nutcase try to kill you?
I'm a coffee importer.
So Mr. Tattoo Man got a bad bunch of beans, is that it? Wanted a cappuccino and got an espresso? You can understand me, right? These words are making sense?
Yes, they are.
Good.
Hey, so, how's it going?
Amazingly well. Thanks to my surgery skills and the prospect of waking up next to you every morning, he should be fine.
Oh, that's great.
But why is a woman like you mixed up with a drug dealer?
Drug dealer? Jason?
If that guy's a coffee importer, I'm the janitor.
No, Jason hates drugs. He doesn't even go near them.
Right, never sample the merchandise. I get it.
No, you don't get it.
Look, I'm not making accusations. I'm just saying I think you could do a lot better.
Really? Okay, well, why don't you try this? You don't need to know what Jason does for a living. And if you try and hit on me again, he'll kill you.
If I have to stay in bed all day, why can't I just be at home?
Because you need to be close to the doctors.
No, I don't like doctors.
Well, you need to stay in bed and heal because you got that big cut in your head.
Okay, well then you need to go home and get some rest.
Okay, I'll take a nap. That's No. What are you doing? Where are you going?
Well, I'm gonna get out of bed if you don't leave.
All right. You know what? This calls for Rochambeau. Don't look at me like that. Rock, paper, scissors. Come on. 3 out of 5.
You know that I'd be.
You win. I go home. I win. I stay. Got it? Good.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Okay, you win. 1, 2, 3. I win. 1, 2, 3. You win. 1, 2, 3. You win.
That's 3, then.
That's 3. Okay.
Out of 5.
You won.
Yeah.
Okay.
The odds always favor rock.
The odds?
Yeah.
You hustled me.
Right.
You hustled me in rock, okay. Paper, scissors.
Now be a good little loser. Go home.
Okay. I love you.
Mm-hmm.
Hey. So I know how much you hate hospital food. I made a special trip for you. Deli Supreme from the Sandwich Meister. You remember?
Yeah, I do.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks.
And some fresh squeezed lemonade. Careful.
Fresh squeeze? I haven't had that for a long time.
It used to be one of your favorites.
Yeah, when I was living in a boxcar.
Mm-hmm. It's not even there anymore. I just happened to drive by it. I guess a lot has changed since then.
Yeah. You haven't.
Really? You don't think so?
Well, you know, you're still very passionate about your work. You like helping people. And you still love being right.
Yes, I do. Which I'm sure can be very annoying sometimes. I wish that I could be more objective like you, especially when I'm doing my research.
Well, because of your research, I got back the last 10 years of my life, so thank you.
Well, I should be thanking you for hanging on just a little bit longer and justifying my work. I guess we always had that understanding between us. I always liked that about you, that we could just sit there for hours and not really say anything. I gotta go to a staff meeting, but enjoy your sandwich.
Need to break the news? He's already taken. Talk about your bedside manner. You were about to jump right in with him, weren't you?
Jason is an old friend. I brought him lunch.
Your own little picnic. Right here on the 10th floor. Fluorescent lights, ambient machine noise, the smell. Doesn't get much more unprofessional than that.
Are you calling me unprofessional?
Why don't you just admit that you're in love with him?
Hey, you been paid yet?
Get back in bed.
If you finished your job and you got paid, you don't need to be here. Get me another doctor.
If you don't get back in bed, I'll have you sedated. And if that doesn't work, I'll put you in restraints. I'm not gonna have you retroactively botch my brilliant surgery because you're moving around too fast.
That's my life, sorry.
Fine. But if you want to keep breathing, you'll do as you're told. Get him in bed.
Sorry, he has a horrible attitude. Just ignore him, okay?
You put up with that guy to save my life.
Of course I did. You know I'd do anything to help you. Hey. Hey, I'm glad you're back. Jason tried to get out of bed. I just settled him back in.
What were you doing out of bed?
Just make sure he stays put, okay? And you listen to her.
Deal was, I go home and you stay in bed.
So why are you here?
Why were you out of bed?
Can't sleep.
Okay, well, neither can I. So I decided to come back because I am a wreck without you. And I also thought that maybe you and I could recuperate together. But we do need a little privacy.
What exactly do you have in mind?
These are perfect. Just like Christmas at home. Except we aren't home, and that definitely isn't our bed. However, I think it'll do.
Antonio.
Whoa. Okay, really sorry about this. But you know what? I don't have a lot of time because I gotta get back to court. And Jason, I really need to talk to you.